Oh, sorry, I was reading. Reading? What's that? It's like tweeting, but clever. No, I felt terrible last night because I did the show last night and Patricia Arquette was on and she was yakety-yak-yak, yakety-yak-yak. And I didn't get time to do the emails, and there were so many emails, and I think, I'm not going to get through them all. So what I said last night is, well, if you come back tomorrow, I'll get through the emails. So what I'll do now is, before the show starts properly, I'll do the emails from last night, sort of. Because tonight's show, well, I won't have time for emails tonight, because the show is so packed full of entertainment and fun. That there will be no time for emails tonight either. And people who enjoy the email segment will be saying, when do we get our medication? And I'll be saying... Anyway, so I'll do the emails tonight. I normally sit over there when I'm doing the emails, but I'm going to do them standing up front here tonight. I look forward to your letters. Oh, I don't like it when you do the emails from there. Have you been drinking? Yeah, that's right. I've been drinking, so I changed email positions. Listen, if I ever start drinking again, it'll be more than changing email positions, all right? Do you know when you look at me and you think, that guy's crazy, and you think, he's probably a bit crazier than he lets on? You're right. Like, is he nuts? Yep. Like, he should probably be locked up a lot of the time. I am locked up a lot of the time. Anyway, so I'll do the email, because we don't have time for these emails tonight. We don't have time for them tonight. That's why I have to do them now. Really? Oh. Seems we've run out of time. However, rest assured that over the weekend, I will look at these emails many times and... I won't. I'm going to throw them away. I'm not. I'll do them now. This is from Gecko in Salt Lake City in Utah. Can I just do one? I'll just do one. All right, I'll put these here. I'll just do one. Because it's from Utah, you know, you don't want to upset the Mormons. Did I upset them by just even saying their name? Oh, come on. No, that can't be... No. Really? All right, you don't want to upset some people who live in Utah, not necessarily Mormons. This is from Gecko in Salt Lake City in Utah. He's not necessarily a Mormon. Actually, with a name like Gecko, probably not, actually. Anyway, he says, I get stoned every night and watch your show. He is not a Mormon. I know I do it. You mess with my head. My parents laugh at me when I'm smoking in front of the television and you say, put the pipe down. All right. Gecko, is it? Gecko, I'd like you to leave the room. I want to have a word with your parents. Out you go. Get out. On you go. Go in. Maybe you could go and make them a cup of coffee. Just get out the room for a minute. Go and play with your toys. Mr. and Mrs. Gecko. All right, you can let them back in. All right, we'll be right back, everybody.
Ladies and gentlemen, Craig Ferguson.
Hello, enough. Thank you. Thank you very much.
Please. That's enough.
And let your applause and your cheering and your genuine joy die away. Oh, it did.
Yeah, we're done, loser. We're done with you.
Hey, look, I know it's just the way out. I've got old man high pants tonight. Oh, yeah.
Old man high pants. You know, old man high pants lives in that place up by the... Hey, yeah. Get off of my lawn, you kids. Ah, old man high pants is yelling at us again.
Yes, it is. What is it? It's a great day for America, everybody. That's what it is.
Friday. Friday.
It's Friday. And a very, very sad news from Hollywood this week. The romance between Justin Timberlake and Jessica Biel is over. Aww. I also am phony upset. Don't worry, though. A beautiful girl like that won't stay single for long. And Jessica's sure to get dates, too. Everything will work out. Are you saying Justin Timberlake looks like a girl? Yeah! No, he doesn't. It's a bet. There's some very big movies opening today. There's a movie called Whip It. I thought, oh, I'm looking forward to this. It'll be about a small dog or something. But no, it's a... I thought, whip it, this will be a movie about Devo, you know. 2 hours of whip it good. Whip it good. But it's not, it's about roller derby. I've always associated roller derby with women of a certain sexual orientation. Let me just say that Lindsay Lohan likes roller derby sometimes. Do you know what I mean? What I'm saying is that I thought roller derby was popular with lesbians. That's what I thought. All over the world, actually, lesbians love roller derby, not just in America. Do we have a picture of the world's greatest roller derby fan? There you are, look at that. She loves the roller derby, that girl. That is one roller derby-loving lesbian. Kim Jong-il, who also enjoys golf, of course. Do we have a picture of Kim Jong-il enjoying golf? There you are. He likes to play golf in Holland, I see. Anyway, there's a movie opening today that I really want to see is Zombieland. Yeah, it's not like Whip It. There's no confusion in the title. You know what you're getting with Zombieland. You're going to get... It's about a land full of zombies. I love zombies. Because if any monster could river dance, it would be zombies. They're like, oh. They're already halfway there. That's what I'm hoping for. River dancing zombies. I can see it on Broadway now. One singular physician. If I wanted to avoid zombies, I wouldn't go to a place called Zombieland. You see, that's what... You know what you're getting, Zombieland. I wouldn't go to Zombieland if I wanted to avoid zombies. It's the same reason I avoid a place called Lake Titicaca. I'd be frightened I would never come home. And then don't get me started about Jackson Hole. Sorry, I mean, Zombieland's it's a horror movie and a comedy, but it's not a romantic comedy. See, that's what I would love to see, a romantic zombie movie, a zom-com. That's what you want. Horror movies are supposed to be allegories for things that humans wrestle with, like the Dracula metaphor, you know, is for sex, you know, the penetrating fangs, the crave the flesh, you know, all that. But you'd think all those young maidens in Transylvania would learn to shut their windows at night, but they're all kind of like, oh, this breeze feels good on my boobies. Oh, I can't get to sleep without sticking my lady's business out the window. Oh, the Transylvania night air.
It makes me glad I'm visiting from England. I always come here for my vacation. So the vampire thing is a metaphor for sex. Dr. Jekyll and Mr. Hyde's a metaphor for alcoholism. He drinks a potion, becomes a monster. I know exactly how he feels. I don't really know what the zombie is an allegory for. Probably stoners. Maybe that's what it is. Must eat brains. Or Twinkies. Anyway, the zombies in this movie, Zombieland, are very excited because they're proper zombies, covered in blood with decaying limbs. That's good. That's good. Because I don't want to see Hollywood ruin zombies like they ruined vampires. I don't like the new I sound like Andy Rooney, don't I?
Don't you hate today's young vampires? Hey, I hate the young vampires. Old man pants. Hey, I hate the young with their leather jackets and their messed up hair. Whatever happened to tuxedos and Braille cream?
What I'm saying is I'm sick of the Twilight vampires with their pasty listening faces and their undead abs of steel. What's that? Is that a vampire? Where do vampires get bodies like that? Where do they go? Vampires that work out? What the hell is wrong with you? They're pasty and thin and go like that. They don't go to a ghoul's gym in the middle of the night. One. Two repetitions. Three repetitions. A vampire should be a silent predator of the night, not some guy you friend up with in MySpace. I know MySpace isn't cool anymore. It's all about FaceTube and TweetyBot. TweetyBot, yeah, that's about TweetyBot. Vampires are behind the times, though. They still use MySpace. They read newspapers, they've got their plasma screens made with real plasma. A blood joke? Well done, Craig. Thank you very much indeed. Right across. Oh, yes. All across America right now. Hematologists are like, finally, a joke for us. You're welcome, hematologists. We'll take a break. We'll be right back, everybody. All right. Everybody, welcome back. Of all the nights to have old man pants, why tonight? Why? Why tonight? The suit I wore last night, I was like, I was like, and the audience were like, wow, and I'm like, yeah. And now look at me tonight, I look like an old douche. You are an old douche. Shut up. Shut up, voice in my head that always tells the truth. My first guest tonight is on the Project Runway show. It's my favourite TV show that isn't on CBS, which, of course, they have all my favourites with...
Somebody's dead.
But the Project Runway, it's a Thursdays on Lifetime, the network for ladies and Europeans. Take a look at this. Look.
Ooh, we had the beach.
There's Santa Monica Pier right there.
We don't have oceans in Minnesota, so it's kind of nice to see the ocean for the first time. So we're walking down the beach, and we see Tim Gunn in sandals and sunglasses, but still in a blazer.
Hi, guys.
Hi. Tim Gunn in flip-flops, it's a stretch.
Only at the beach.
Please welcome the icon that is the wonderful Tim Gunn, everybody. Tim, it's lovely
to see you.
It's lovely to see you too. And if you're an old douche, think what I am.
No, Tim, I feel awful because look how wonderfully turned out you are. You look fantastic. Everything, you've made it work.
I would say you've made it work too. And frankly, other than color, we're Thai twins.
No, but look at I've got old man pants. can you help me with the old man pants?
We'll talk.
Yes, I know. I'm sorry, the audience for some reason is locked into double entendres. I have no idea why.
I can't imagine.
Well, I know, someone's encouraging them. I am very much enjoying this year's season of Project Runway.
It's
really wonderful, and I think I'm a little concerned about you in L.A.
I loved being in L.A.
Well, yes, but I think of you as a creature of the night, if you don't mind me saying so. Like, you know, a creature of the darkness, and I'm implying vampire in a certain way, but...
You're not far off course when you say that.
Well, you're quite light-skinned.
Indeed, I'm almost transparent.
Yeah, and I worry about you in the belting heat of the California...
Well, I made certain to wear plenty of sunscreen, and you could see on the beach I was fully clothed, but for the flip-flops, and I thought, I can't wear dress shoes on the beach. How preposterous would that be?
Yeah.
Filling with sand, and I couldn't be shoeless because that sand is hot.
Well, you're Tim Gunn. You could have had the beach partially paved. You could have had something. They would do it for you.
Yeah, they probably would have paved me into it.
Heidi, she would do that.
That would happen for her.
Yeah, she
totally
would.
Agree.
Yeah, she's very powerful.
And she would float through in a sedan chair.
Yeah. Now listen, I'm enjoying the show this year. I was a little concerned that I thought it was unfair that Ramon was taken off. I thought that dress was awful, the green one, but he had done so much good work up until then, I thought he should have...
Well, you know what the trouble is? The designers are extremely talented.
Yes, they are, yeah.
And it's very difficult to say goodbye to any of them, I have to say. And as I remind them, and they can become very myopic in that workroom, they're only looking at their own work, and I say to them, look around, because one of you is going home. It's Project Runway Musical Chairs. By definition, someone's going to go home.
Project Runway Musical?
What do you think?
I think it would work. Now, listen, think about it. Demographically, people who enjoy Project Runway also probably enjoy musicals. I think you know where I'm going. Project Runway the Musical, I think, could work.
But I have to tell you, speaking of our demographic, when we were in Los Angeles taping, we were taping. I was living in an apartment that was a block from where we were taping, and between me and the set was a construction site. Mm-hmm. And I had construction workers yelling out at me, "Tim Gunn, you're killing me with that show."
Really?
So there's a whole new demographic.
No. This is Los Angeles construction. It's a whole different type of construction.
It's done with a tutu and a tiara.
Yeah, that's right. Tim Gunn, I swear. Will the next season be in L.A. as well? Is it going to be in L.A. from now on?
I hope I'm not giving away secrets. We actually have taped the bulk of season 7, following season, in New York.
Oh, right. So you're back in New York, yes. I feel good about that.
I'm confident we're returning to Los Angeles.
What about taking it to different cities each season? What about Project Runway Detroit?
Sorry. I will say this with impunity. Los Angeles really is the other fashion capital of this nation.
Oh, really?
And I don't know of another city that can really compare.
Well, I think there's a lot of people showing too much skin in this town. People have got no business wearing the kind of things they're wearing. I think,
We'll get no argument or debate from me.
Yeah, right. That kind of ruins the show, actually, too. I kind of need a bit of an argument or some kind of debate.
No.
At least a conversation, man.
Yes, there's way too much skin shown on the
show. Yeah, it's ghastly. I think that, you know, there's some people here that I think, you know, just wear a coat.
Well... And also the proliferation and pervasiveness of plastic surgery.
And
the worst part is you really do get kind of numb to the whole thing. It's like the monkey house at the zoo. I'm always talking about it. And the fact of the matter is, I do. You walk into the monkey house and you think, this place stinks. And in 20 minutes you think, doesn't smell so bad. And after an hour you think, what smell?
Yes.
But anyone new walking in thinks, this place stinks. So it still does.
That is... That is Los Angeles. I have a theory about plastic surgery, Andy.
What is it?
Well, I don't think it's anything to do with appearance at all. I think what it is that when people, men and women, reach a certain point in their lives that they're not getting the kind of attention that they used to get, then you go and see a plastic surgeon and you've got all these young, hot doctors going, looking at it. And it's really about the attention that gets focused on you. And the plastic surgery is just a byproduct for a deeper emotional neediness.
Very well said. But I will say this. I can understand it with women, and this is not, well, I won't go any further than that. I can understand it with women, but is there anything sadder than a man who's had plastic surgery?
Well,
it's sad.
It is a little bit, yeah, it's, but I'm going to have some, though.
What are you having done? You need nothing.
I'm gonna have my stomach removed. Well, partially, you know.
But that's a whole different form of surgery. It's not facial.
No. I might have some done here, you know.
No, see? You're the Joker. It's scary.
I think I look good. I look like I'm traveling at a high speed.
Monkey house,
no, I wouldn't do it. But you notice that New York women and European women, they tend to go more for, like, they just say, no plastic surgery, you get a fabulous coat. That's what they do, isn't it?
I would prefer that.
Yeah,
yeah, absolutely.
I've got a great fashion thing. Now, the First Lady, she's a very good example of fashion. Have you met her?
Oh, and I, on July 24th at the White House, in fact, I did meet her.
You did?
Yes.
You met Michelle? Sleeves or
fabulous.
No sleeves?
No sleeves.
No sleeves. Even with Tim Gunn in the room. She was like, nah.
She was wearing a shift by Michael Kors.
Right.
Beautiful shade of yellow. And she, well, more fabulous than even my expectations allowed me to be prepared for.
Really?
And a natural conversationalist and warm. And, I mean, you just feel like you want to give her a big hug.
Oh, I'd be too scared.
Well, I didn't.
Hey, you mentioned Michael Kors, though. I did notice this year that the Michael Kors and the Nina Garcia are not the regular judges. I'm concerned.
Well, what happened was we madly dashed into season 6 to tape it, and I was very fortunate. I could change my schedule at Liz Claiborne,
right,
and was more than happy to do so, and I have great colleagues who work with me. Nina had to cover the European shows. We had just finished New York Fashion Week when we began taping, and
so
Michael
doing
had
their real jobs,
yeah
then.
Michael yeah. had commitments yeah. to, with textile mills in Italy, and it was hard for them. They will return, but you know, I felt bad for Heidi because she was doing all the heavy lifting. She was the one, when we have three guest judges, Heidi's the one who says, when they're all extolling the praises of a dress that walks down the runway, she says, but I've seen this dress 4 other times
right.
from the same designer, and they say, we haven't.
I would never feel bad for Heidi. Yeah. That's a very powerful woman. She could break you.
I adore her.
I'm very frightened of her.
No.
Yes, she's strict looking. I mean, it's sexy, don't get me wrong. But I'm kind of scared and enthralled. I think a lot of people feel that. Anyway, listen, Tim, we're out of time, but will you come back again?
I'd be thrilled to.
Thank you. And I am always very, very... I feel awkward when you're here because I always seem to be dressed so badly.
You're never dressed badly.
Oh, Tim,
I see you
so
all the
kind.
Time.
Look at me. Look at me. I'm wearing Bob Barker's old suit from The Price is Right. I feel terrible. Honestly, last night, you should have been here last night. I was like, and people were like, Tim, it's lovely to see you again.
Wonderful.
Lovely
to
Tim Gunn, everybody. We'll be right back. Welcome back, everybody. Welcome back to the big fashion night where I'm dressed non-threateningly. My next guest stars in How I Met Your Mother, which is at Monday nights at 8 o'clock right here on CBS. But it's good. This is CBS we're talking about, right? That in this show, you'd be like, you can't do that. Thankfully. Please welcome the lovely Kobe Smulders, everybody. Kobe Smulders. Hi, Kobe.
That that clip kind of took me by surprise. I just had a baby, and I just realized the benefits of having a child from that clip.
Well, what do you mean?
The upper portion of my body is slightly different these days.
Ah, from having a baby.
Yes.
It didn't look that bad before the baby,
Oh, jeez.
No, that's a bit racy for CBS.
It is a bit racy, yeah. Yeah, I know. We got moved to 8, too, so we had to cut some stuff down.
I have to see more.
You'll have to tune in.
I'm going
to
start watching CBS. Good. I'm doing it. I'm canceling my cable.
Yes.
No. Hey, Tim Gunn was here.
I know. I kind of had like a little girlish moment back
then. Me too.
Just came out. Yeah.
Are you in awe of Tim Gunn's fashion?
I am. I think he's amazing, and he just said something nice about my outfit. So
I don't blame him.
Really,
it's awesome.
May I
say, I do like your outfit. It's kind of it matches a few genres. You've got like lady
pearls,
at nighttime,
yes,
and then science fiction. It's like Lady from Another Planet.
Yeah, that's what I was going for.
Lady Ninja.
Mutant from Another Planet today.
No, I'm so glad you got that.
Like sexy lady from another.
Sexy lady from another planet with a baby. You just had a baby.
I did. Yeah.
Yeah. What age?
4 months.
When it was born?
Yeah. It was a tough delivery.
Yeah. Wow.
It was rough.
No, what did you have? A girl,
yeah. No,
what's her name?
Shaylin.
Shaylin, that's a lovely name. Is that Irish?
It's Gaelic, but not, you know, we didn't choose it that way. It just sort of like, we just like the sound of it.
You know, Shaylin,
we're not Gaelic.
Are you going to teach her to river dance?
Yes.
Yeah.
Absolutely.
You should, because with a name like Shaylin. Ladies and gentlemen, Shaylin, and she'll come out and... Hey, diddly day do day diddly day day. Is Smulders an Irish name?
No, it's Dutch.
Dutch?
Yeah.
Clogs?
with the kilt and the clogs, my daughter is just going
to
be...
Have you ever been to Holland?
Yeah,
really?
A few times. Yeah, I saw family over there.
Did you see the dykes? Grow up! Did you see them? Did you see the sea walls?
I sure did.
They're awesome.
Yes, the sea walls, yes.
Yeah, that's what they call them. They call them dykes.
Yeah, yeah. Yeah. Isn't there like a nursery rhyme with something about a boy and the...
Puts his finger in a dyke?
Yeah.
He saves the entire country.
He does.
Yeah. Enormous risk to himself, I would imagine.
Yeah, I would imagine.
Yeah. Now, were you in Amsterdam? Did you go there?
I did not when I was old enough to really enjoy Amsterdam. I was like 12.
You don't want to go to Amsterdam when you're 12. You'll miss the whole thing.
I know.
Yeah, I know.
I know.
Mind you, if you go when you're 25, you'll miss the whole thing as well.
It's true.
You're not...
No, but my sister played basketball for the Dutch national team.
Shut up!
Yeah, she's a baller.
Wow!
Yeah.
Do you play basketball?
No, I wish. No. She's very athletic and very talented.
You don't play any sports at all?
I played soccer for 12 years, but that's just because I could run. I don't really have any athletic talent or anything.
Running is an athletic talent.
That's true. I'd probably die now if I had to play a full game.
No. I'm sure you could just stand there and wear your boots.
Just...
Yeah. Now, did you play... You didn't grow up in Holland, though, did you?
Canada. Vancouver.
Oh, I'm sorry.
Yeah. It's okay. We get made fun of all the time.
No, I make fun of Canada because I kind of feel Canada's like family. Because there's so many Scottish people live there, I kind of feel that I can make fun of Canada.
And they won't
roast me over a spit.
Yeah, we might.
I know you might, but you'd be polite about it.
Absolutely.
Really sorry we're
just
doing
slow,
this, eh?
Slow and gentle.
Do you still go up to Vancouver all the time?
Yeah, I mean, now that I have a child, traveling's a little bit more difficult.
Is your daughter Canadian or American?
She's American.
Oh, good. Well, that's good.
It's great. It's sort of strange because I'm not. You know, it's like... It's just
Do you
odd.
Feel that she kind of has an air of superiority
a
over you?
A little bit. A bit of an attitude.
Yeah, a little bit like, oh, Mom, go back to your own country.
I can be president and you can't.
Yeah, she can be president and you can't be president.
I know.
Yeah.
I know.
Are you an American citizen?
No.
That's going to get in the way, too.
I know.
Yeah, I'm going
to get deported.
Yeah, you know, you can't. See, I'm an American citizen and I still can't be president.
Well, I know. You have the new book out.
Yeah, I do.
About the whole thing. Like I saw it on my table when I came in, and I thought you're the only man who can pull off the combat boots and the kilt.
No, that's very popular wear back home in Scotland. It is. No, guys walk around leather jackets, kilts,
really?
And combat boots. Yeah.
Really?
Yeah, they do well with that.
Wow. I would imagine.
Yes, they do. You know what they call it, actually? I'm not kidding you.
Okay.
Result wear.
Okay. Works
true.
For me.
That's true.
Works for me.
You must have seen that up in Canada. There's hundreds of Scottish people up in Canada.
Yeah,
thousands
of
them.
It's cold up there, though. I mean, there's not a lot of skirts. Men's skirts.
Why?
Because it's...
Why
know,
did you say
you
that?
Don't
Why
any,
did you,
don't,
you say skirt?
Well, you don't wear anything underneath the thing, so it gets...
You don't, but it's still warm under there.
For some, maybe.
No, there's a whole system of air flows.
I was not aware. This isn't dirty.
It is dirty. It's kind of dirty. I feel insecure because Tim was here, and I feel kind of.
You look great.
No, it's too.
I don't know what
now.
You're talking about. Your pants. No. Your pants look great.
No, you look great. I just look like an old man.
No, that's
yeah,
true.
I do. I look like old man high pants. Old man high pants. Did you ever get chased by a creepy old guy in your neighborhood?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I can imagine. Because that's kind of like doing this show now, isn't it? Hey, come on and sit by me. Ooh. Tell me all your news. Yeah. We're out of time, actually.
Oh, really? Mm. That's unfortunate.
A little bit, yeah.
I'm having such a good time.
Yeah, really. You could try and be a little more sincere with that. You know, man. It would really help me get through the rest of the show.
Oh, no. Mm. What else?
Nothing.
Yeah.
I got a tattoo. Yeah.
I heard about this. Are you revealing what it is? What is a snake?
Yeah, it's a partial snake. Yeah, it goes all the way up round there and ends up in my peepee.
No, it does. Wow. It's kind of like a.
It's a paper trail. You know what I mean? It's like a. It's like you start there and then you go on a journey.
And there's a few dead ends, but we get there.
No, there are. Dead ends.
I want to get one, actually,
Don't get one there.
No? Because it's painful, yeah?
Oh, my Lord, I saw the baby Jesus from over there. I swear. You know when you see guys with a lot of tattoos and it stops about there?
Yeah.
That's because they know.
Because they weaned out.
And you can't cry in the tattoo parlor. I don't like it.
Not with, like, these huge, beefy guys tattooing you, I'm sure.
It wasn't a beefy guy that tattooed me. He was quite beefy.
Yeah.
He was gorgeous. We're out of time. We really have to go. Will you come back again?
Absolutely.
The lovely Kobe Smulders, everybody. We'll be right back. Guests right here in the studio, the legendary Southern Rockers performing Simple Life from their new album Gods and Guns. Lynyrd Skynyrd, everybody, Lynyrd Skynyrd.
Hey, when was the last time you sat down and had dinner with the kids? Talk about what's going on in their lives. Last time you just stopped and helped somebody out, I bet you can't remember. Well, a lot of people say we're changing for the better, but that don't interest me. I like the simple life the way it used to be. We left our doors wide open. I wanna get up Sunday morning and go fishing with my boy. Watch the sunset kick back in my yard. Take my Harley on a real long, lazy Sunday drive. And do a little more nothing once in a while. Yeah, maybe kick my feet up, watch an old rerun on TV. Laughing with old Barney, Andy, and Abby. I like the simple life the way it used to be.
Farty cat.
I tell you, I'm rocked out with Leonard Skinner being here. I just don't feel I have any rock left in me. I'm completely rocked out. Like, if I was to be examined by a doctor right now, he would say, or she, ladies can be doctors too. I look forward to your letters. If I was to be examined by a doctor now, he or she would say, I'm afraid you're rocked out. You're going to have to go home and relax and wait until your rock builds up again. Take these pills, and if you experience a rock lasting more than 4 hours... Come on! Not even when I was 15! 4 hours? Shut up! I mean, I know it's a wonder drug and everything, but get over yourself! 4 hours? Wow. 4 hours. Oh! What? I can't talk about this? Oh, I can. Well, I'm doing it. Leonard Skinner were here. I'm rocked out. What else can I do? Man, you can still feel the energy in the studio. Do you know, I'm rocked out. I got a tattoo. One of the guys in Leonard Skinner went to the same tattoo place as me and got some tattoos done. And I said, it's really sore, isn't it, Leonard? And he's like, no. And I was like, you're right, I was just pretending to be a wuss. I could take that for 4 hours. Have a nice weekend. Good night, everybody.